Hi, I'm Tankfish, and I collect people. Welcome to All-Star Tower Defense, a game where you kidnap kids and, depending on their quality, send them to the slaughterhouse to liquidate and extract their experience, or dispatch them to the battlefield to fight off endless hordes of enemies who are here to get some of your hentai collection. You know, giving them a good taste of what fighting on the Eastern Front on the German side feels like. And just like any Roblox anime games, this one doesn't make sense neither. Because theoretically, if you just place Goku on any of those maps, it should be a rather easy victory. Cause those Dragon Ball people are on a whole different scale. They blow up planets for shits and giggles. The only explanation I can think of is plot armor, aka the strongest defense that bends reality. Take the most generic ass tower defense game, make it anime, put a shitload of towers, and you got All-Star Tower Defense. Hold on, let me turn up the quality. What the f- If you want me to describe the experience in one word, it's pain. 5% of the gameplay is you placing down your units and upgrading them, and the other 95% is you doing absolutely fuck all. All of the maps only have one lane, so you don't need to spend extra brain cells to figure out where choke points are. Just put your towers near the enemy spawn. It's not called spawn camping, it's called denying enemy reinforcement. Sometimes the route doesn't even make sense. Look at this. Why did you make this detour? You could literally just have walked straight. The f*** is this, gay parade? Anyways, do I even have to explain how this game works? Like, this is such a textbook tower defense that you can say the creator might as well copy the f*** textbook. You know, upgrade towers, get money after rounds, don't let enemies reach your base. Yeah, I'm not gonna waste your time with the basic shits. I mean, so simple that even infants play this game. And they do. Your base HP scales with your level, and by that I mean every one level gives you 4 extra HP, which is f*** all. More players also give more HP to the base, but also make the monster stronger. The damage the monster deal to the base depends on their HP remaining, so if you let a fat one in, you're pretty much fucked. Oh yeah, some units require the high ground, so don't be dumb like me and try to place Goku on the ground for like 30 minutes. So yeah, that's about it for the gameplay. Now some tips. If you don't have good units, call in a friend and leech off them. If you don't have any brain cell for a good team composition, you got the internet, you can do plagiarism. Nice. Just remember to disable the effects when playing, cause you will f***ing crash. The enemies are basically walking punching bags, and by walking I mean they move at the same velocity as a disabled grandma. This is how fast these motherfuckers move in anime, and this is how fast they move in game. Like, are they on f***ing life support or something? They also lack critical thinking, cause they just walk by people who are literally beating the shit out of them. Like, six man, go gank this dude or something. You got the numbers. When it's balloons, right? Fine, makes sense. Balloons don't fight back, but these are not f***ing balloons. Anyway, sorry I got sidetracked. There are multiple types of enemies. Normal, simply walk on the path like good boys running an errand. Powerful, got plot armor, can only be damaged by upgraded units. Decelerate, those are 7 years old to marathon. They will sprint and be fast as f*** in the beginning and eventually run out of breath and slow down. Air. I don't know, but if you're flying, do you still need to follow the f***ing road? Like, they can be only attacked by people on the high ground or hybrid units. Explosive. Unlock bot upon death and stun your characters. It's one of the only enemies that actually kind of fight back, but you have to retaliate by sacrificing yourself for Pakistan. Cloner. Does mitosis when dying. Regenerator. Regens health. Bounce. Pretty much is a very big punching bag. Though some have some special gimmicks such as stunning units or directly attacking your base. So yeah, that's the other enemy that fights back. And that's pretty much it. Also the you mean by flying titans, Cloner, Todoroki, and Deku Nani the f- What is this, a fan fiction? This game has a gacha system, aka legal PG gambling for children. You use gems to summon main units and coins to summon secondary units. To be honest, as a recovered patient from terminal gacha addiction, this game's summon system is not that f***ing annoying. I mean, sure, the gacha only has 6 characters with 1 5 stars, 2 4 stars, and 3 3 stars, and changes every hour. But all this means is that you can get a specific character without wasting your gems. You might have to wait forever for the 5 star you want to appear, since there's like 90 of them. But hey, at least that's better than having 0.02% chance of getting the unit you want. Just be careful, cause some characters have similar avatars, so make sure to not get jebaited. I mean, there is, after all, 8 f***ing different versions of Goku. Oh, also, there's a pity system where you can get a guaranteed 5 stars after 60 rows, though the pity resets when you leave the server. The f*** is this, YBA? know what, I'm not even gonna make fun of the scuffed character names. It honestly seems that the Roblox anime game devs are having a competition of who can come up with the most scuffed name at this point. They're not even trying anymore. You can equip 6 units at a time. You start at 3 and unlock new slot at level 15, 30, and 50. Different units have a different cap for the amount of time you can place them on the map. Usually you can place 8 at a time, but some stronger ones like Gilgachan can only be placed once. Sometimes the attack pattern of your unit changes when you upgrade it, and some units unlock abilities at certain upgrades. To be honest, this game doesn't even try to be balanced. Some units are like on f***ing crack, and some seem to have a crippling depression episode. You can level up your characters by forcing them to cannibalize other, weaker individuals, and evolve your characters by offering specific people to the Blood God. This is a PG game, by the way. In fact, secondary units is just a better way to say human sacrifice. I mean, you could use them in battle to make your teammates have a gamer rage moment, but that's pretty much the extent of their use. I mean, your basement, aka your inventory, has limited space anyways, and expanding it costs gems, so might as well, you know? The only way to obtain 6-star units is through evolution, and your units keep their levels after evolving. The fuck is this, Pokemon? Each level gives the character 1% damage buff, so at max level, they will receive a 79% damage buff. They should've made the level cap 70. The unit in your first slot will show up on your shoulder. That's your favorite child. And just like any Asian parents, you should show them off, you know, flex on the others.
Hey, look, my kid knows how to play piano. Well, shut the f*** up, my 3-year-old can do algebra.
Me, personally, I want to throw them in a nearby river for some reason. Anyways, although it seems like there's a shitload of units, most of them are DPS, and by most, I mean like 95%. You may think that they're all different, but they're actually just all copy-pasted with different skins and animation. I mean, for f***ing sake, the damage is dealt instantaneously and the animation is just for show. So most of the time, the enemies would just get f***ing Thanos snapped out of existence. Then your unit will have a skill issue moment and attack fuck all nothing. Anyways, I digress. All the DPS pretty much follow 3 archetypes: single target, cone, and AoE. Good units basically have higher damage, more range, and bigger AoE. That's about it. The other 5% of units are the fun ones. They are summoners that summon goons to kamikaze on the enemies. Classic Japan, I know. Units that deal damage over time. While the f***ing hype machines that increase surrounding units' testosterone level. Slaves that make you money. And units with special abilities. For example, Goku and Vegeta with gay earrings can do the big gay move and fuse. Blackbeard can slow enemies. Some f***ers have manual activated damage abilities. I don't know why people like these, because all this means is that you can't AFK anymore. Jotaro can Zavardo and freeze his enemies. Gojo too for some reason, even though he f*** all has a time stop ability in canon. And you can directly control Kakashi, Susanoo, or get in the f***ing robot. There are more, but too long didn't read. Go and wiki yourself. Give your characters balls to buff them. Okay, orbs are pretty overpowered. They give some plot armor, awakening, flintstone, vitamin gummy, monster energy tier buffs. And that's why each unit can only equip one. Most of the orbs are unit specific, but some can be used by anyone. They can be bought with gems obtained in trials or crafted with materials. They take a shitload of materials to craft though, so you might have to sell both of your kidneys to get one. Holy shit, that's a lot of game modes. Alright, so there's the story mode with absolutely f*** all story and zero dialogues. You just play through the levels, I guess. Every level with the same map are pretty much identical, with a few tweaks to the monster health and a different boss. So basically, you can just use the same strat. Beating the level gives you a secondary character used for evolution and EXP. There are 20 maps with 6 levels each, so 120 in total. Have fun. Infinity mode is basically fighting against China, because the enemies just keep on coming until you're dead. Every 10 waves, you get an EXP to feed your starving children. And by that I mean a character that's just called EXP. The devs gave up on code and said f*** it and just made a unit whose sole purpose is to be sacrificed. You can play on extreme in both of these modes where you get butt f***ed but receive more rewards. There's a PvP mode where you can either engage in glorious duel or team up with a bro and 2v2. The goal is to outlast your opponent and you can summon bosses that you bought with gems or coin to your enemy's side to cuck them. Basically to win, be the first one to boss spam the sh** out of the other guy. You gain or lose elo depending if you win or lose, and you receive a PvP rank based on your elo. It has no use and it's pretty much just for flexing. Trials are basically story mode with a level requirement. You get a 5-star unit as a reward for normal mode completion, orbs, or extreme mode, and I have no fucking idea why trials have dialogues, not story mode. Raids are basically harder trials that can be played with 8 people. Time Chamber is where you AFK with auto-clicker to get some rewards. Good way to trick kids into staying in your game so it stays on the front page. Basically child labor. Very pog. Material Farm is just infinite mode that drops you materials to craft balls with. Finally, there's the challenge mode, aka the pain in the ass mode. You need specific units to win because all other units have gay debuffs. It's pretty annoying. So yeah, it's just f***ing tower defense. All the game modes are just f***ing tower defense, but with different rewards and difficulty. What did you f***ing expect? There's mounts that you get after completing chapters in story modes. They don't give you any speed boosts and are just there for show and for you to make cringy anime reference to. Now you can also display more starving children from your basement with Bobux and buy Fortnite dances with coins in the shop. And I don't know, those are pretty useless. But hey, some people like to do weird flexes, that's okay. Here's how the grinding works. You place down your towers and shit, then you fuck off doing something else. YouTube, Pornhub, and hentai, whatever. Have fun. Then you come back to spend your money every once in a while, and then rinse and repeat. While you go to sleep or to school, get your ass in the time chamber slash sex dungeon, open your future AI overlord, and AFK. The game plays all the fucking same in different game mode, but you still have to grind in different game mode for the different shits you need. Do not forget to pray to RNGesus 3 times a day to get good rolls in summon and receive materials you actually need in material farm and for good teammates. Level will naturally come if you just keep playing. And finally, gems. Oh, gems. Your suffering will never end. It doesn't end. This is the root to your gambling addiction. The best way to grind it is to finish tasks, daily missions, and all that f***ing bullshit. In fact, you get a shitload of them from your damage task, but once those run out, you'll probably look like a coke addict struggling to get a little sniff as you're farming for gems in story mode and PvP. You'll have so little payout that you'll experience firsthand what working in a dead-end 9-to-5 feels like. If you're tired of this pleb grinding shit, nothing a little microtransaction cannot solve. Congrats, you have probably killed so many shits in this tower defense game that you can be called genocide extraordinaire. Now, you're probably a sweat who has most of the meta units. You can rage at teammates for not having good shits, grind for champion rank to flex, and collect every character and complete your Pokédex. So that will be really f***ing painful to do. There's also a leaderboard for the top 20. They get 1,000 gems and a 6-star unit, but holy shit. Are you not bored of the game yet? You're literally doing the same f***ing thing for the last month. I literally got bored after 4 games. In fact, I paid my little sister to farm in this game. Being a child, of course, she didn't know that she was being severely underpaid. I paid her like 500 Bobux per week. Yeah. If you did the farming yourself, props on you, my man. You deserve a medal. I don't even know if you just have a lot of perseverance, determination, and tenacity, or just half bored to death and has nothing better to do at this point. Anyways, that's about it. Subscribe and spam me in the comment section, and I'll release a child from my basement. So subscribe and save a child, I guess.